Hi, this is Cooking Abba. Well, I'm trying to make quite a different style of bihun soup today. Okay, if not so, I'm going to do it stages by stages with all the different ingredients. First, I heat up some broth together with some. I use the extra soup where I actually boil my bihun. So before this, I already boiled my bihun for about one minute in under the hot water, boiling water, and then take it out after about 1 minute plus a little bit, and I cover with a plate like this to make it more springy, I think. Then I got prawn, big double XL prawn, which I bought it this morning. And a beautiful two cutlets of wild deep sea barramundi. This is actually, cannot see the shiny color from the flesh. This is how fresh it is. I actually recorded a separate video on how to choose a fish together with a prawn. So you can go to my YouTube, my Cooking Abba YouTube channel to take a look. See how shiny is the meat here. Okay. So with the broth here, let me quickly blanch my veggie. Initially, I thought of steaming everything, you know, like a steaming bihun and seafood, but I don't seem to have the right tool, and the timing can be quite tricky. Have you tried steam seafood bihun before? I think I tried in somewhere in the north of Malaysia. I can't remember where. Spinach. My wife loved this because it's very good for breast milk. My wife is still breastfeeding my baby girl after 1 year. Okay. Almost done. Very quick. This dish will not be as soupy as you thought, okay? It's like one dish for all. I will put it at the side. These are some of the garlic that I actually added in, the fried garlic I added in to add the flavor. Okay, let it continue boil. As you can see, this will become the base of my dish. After that, I'm adding in the bihun, which I already boiled. Now it becomes more springy because I have covered it just now after I boiled. can see, this is the second layer, bihun on top of the blanched veggie. Now I'm going to cook my fish. Imagine this, how this broth is going to taste later. It's going to be very flavorful. Cover it. The fish will need a couple of minutes. I mentioned just now, I made two videos just now on how to pick a fresh fish and fresh prawns. I think one thing I didn't really mention in my video was, look at the colors, it must be very shiny. Let it boil for a couple of minutes. From now on, I will try to make a pre-recording video instead of Facebook Live, because I find Facebook Live videos are the quality of the videos are really not so great. So if I do pre-recording like this, I can actually upload a high depth a full HD file, so that you all can actually see clearer on what am I exactly cooking there. I think let's not waste time, we can actually add in the prawns right now. This is double XL prawns. I bought it at a discounted price just now at 95 ringgit per kg. I think it's a good bargain. Deep sea tiger prawn at 95 ringgit. The smaller one also, they are selling at about 80, and that is not even half the size of this. Can you see the colors of the fish, how white it is? You can actually tell from the color when one is done. Look at the whitish color, then you know how fresh is this fish. And this place where I bought the fish, when you bought a big fish from them, they will cut it, wash it and cut it into small cutlets. And they will tap out like this. They will pack all the fish like this for you. See? So it actually becomes very convenient. When you need anyone, you just take it out. You don't. Usually I will tap out myself after I bought the fish at home, but this one, they've done it for me. So it saves my time a lot. Well, of course, after you take it out, like what I mentioned in my previous video, make sure you always wash the fish thoroughly, especially the kidney. Remember, where's the kidney? Yes, it is in the blood. It is the blood stain that was attached in the middle bone. That is the kidney of the fish, and that is the source of the fishy smell. I think my fish is done. fish is done. But I need to be very careful not to spoil the shape. Oops. Open a little bit. Slowly fold it over the bihun. Almost done. See how easy this fish, this recipe is. I put my fish over on top of the bihun like this. The prawn is actually quite big, so I'll give it about 1 minute more to let it fully cook. After finish everything, then I will taste the broth and season the broth. Alright, done. I believe it's done. You know, prawn shells are very useful. You can use prawn shell to create some very, very nice broth. Some people just throw the prawn shell away, which is very wasteful. Okay, now let me slightly season the soup. I have all the seafood sweetness. Now all I need to do is give it a bit of saltiness, followed by a pinch of sugar, and that's my fish sauce. A bit of fish sauce. You don't want to use soy sauce because it will change the color. Okay, maybe a bit of white pepper. I don't really use any MSG or any chicken powder. Okay, but this is really personal preference. You can use it if you want to. A bit of Shaoxing wine. Alright. And then I'm going to pour over this to my bihun. Okay, you will actually slowly absorb my soup later. Okay. Last but not least, adding my garlic oil. I can finish using my garlic oil today because I've made some fresh garlic oil in the afternoon just now. I also recorded a separate video on how I do the how I make the homemade garlic oil. And you can final garnish it with some green onions or fresh coriander. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you very much.